last was one a firm spiritual poise, a constant lodging in the eternal realm, a safety in the silence and the rain, a settlement in the immutable, through ups and downs progresses the aspiring soul. It is led to a well-founded poise. It can lead it on the summits of possibility. The look of the mortal mind is widened. The gap between man's course and the universal fate is narrowed. A bridge is built between the opposing positions. The fragment being is made whole. The fragments have disappeared, and there stands the unified one single being. The disparate entities pulling things in one direction or the other find a fulfilling purpose in their coming together. Now the lodging is in the eternal realm, in Brahman, a constant lodging in the eternal realm. The dwelling is in the immutable. There is a safety in the silence and the rain. The spirit gives its ascent to the still heights and to the troubled depths. It gives the ascent to both equally. Unaltered peace is one. Supernal ground is a base for all activity. Sorrow and delight trouble no more the aspirant soul. Instead, there is a poise of tranquil strength in the life's dynamism. Ashwapati is now the creator of a new luminous art. He is a sculptor, chiseling deity, or the stone offered to him by nature. Thus is God found in nature, and nature fulfilled in God. Everything of him gathers into a single sun. No wonder the eagles of omniscience stoop down. All knowledge is at his command, is in his possession. The tantric distinction is between the animal man, the hero man, the divine man, Pashu, Veera, Deva. Or we may grade the difference according to three gunas. First, the tamasic or rajaso tamasic, man ignorant, inert, or moved only in a little light by small motive forces. That is the first, rajaso tamasic. The rajasic or sato rajasic man, struggling with an awakened mind and will to a self-development or self-affirmation. And the third, the sattvic man, open in mind and heart and will to the light, standing at the top of the scale and ready to transcend it. That is the change which has to take place in the spiritual journey of Ashwapati. Here you also find children of Lucifer claiming to be the goddess. One manifestation of it is a present-day nihilistic approach towards nature, thinking that it is all meant to serve a purpose, his purpose, for me and my use the universe was made. That is what this man says, this titan. This is what he asserts.